Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is, holy crap, someone's getting sued. I mean, seriously, someone is going to get sued over this entire situation. There was a massive leak that came out a couple of days ago, and I've actually been dancing around the idea of making a video about it because so many people have been getting copyright strikes, and some people have been getting copyright strikes for just simply bringing up the situation. Now that I'm seeing more mainstream media cover the situation, I think that I'm okay to cover it as well. Just note, I'm not going to show you any images or the video itself. So what was the video and why is it so bad? The video that leaked a couple of days ago was a commercial for Warzone. This commercial was showing a ton of different stuff, including an updated version of Verdansk, and we're gonna discuss that here. One major thing to note and why somebody is really in big trouble, the commercial itself was not finished. There were still sections of it where you could see the green screen behind the actors. You could still see certain things that weren't cut out of the frame. Transitions weren't there properly. Certain things in the commercial were still blocked out, meaning the CGI wasn't done at all. And it was just kind of there as placeholder, which is something you obviously don't want someone to see when you're going to be putting out a commercial for one of the biggest games in the world, right? So this was a pretty serious situation, and I'm sure somebody's getting sued and someone most definitely got fired. The question comes down to, how did they even obtain the video? I'm sure it's something to do with sending over the video file to the editors, and somewhere in between that it got picked up and then put online. I'm sure Activision already knows the source, and I'm sure that they've sent their very own FBI to people's houses. But anyway, within this commercial, we got a glimpse of updated Verdansk, and it really did surprise all of us because for the past few months, we've been talking about this transition from Verdansk to the Ural Mountains. The Ural Mountains being the completed map of the Fireteam maps from Black Ops Cold War. We've been talking about this, we've been preaching about it, and we've been questioning, like, how's it going to work? You know, players can't technically swim, and there's lots of water on, you know, that map. Like, Sanatorium is pretty much half water, so how would that work in general? And then, from this particular commercial, we see that they're not going to be going that route. In fact, from the commercial itself, it looks like they're going to be going back in time. And I'm trying to wrap my head around how that's going to work if this event is planned to nuke Verdansk. How are we going to go back in time? The only thing that I can think of is they're going to be doing some sort of flashback where maybe the nuke is incoming and you have this kind of your life is flashing before your eyes moment, and it does this flashback and it puts you on a different version of Verdansk. The point is, instead of the Ural Mountains, it looks like we're going to be going to Verdansk in the 1980s in some sort of flashback or rewind. Even through the commercial, there was a rewind noise, so I'm trying to make heads or tails of the situation. We did get a chance to see some key locations from the 1980s version of Verdansk. So instead of having the location where the stadium is in the process of being built in the 1980s. So there's a gigantic crane that's there. There's items that are scattered all around, building material. There are some of the lights that have been built on one side, but the stadium is like halfway gone. There really isn't any huge walls. There's no roof on the stadium. From what we were able to see from this commercial that leaked, there's no windows or anything of the sort like that. Just open archways that you can walk around on the outside. A lot of that modern technology that we see with like the food court and stuff like that doesn't seem to exist. The food court doesn't seem to exist. I think that the parking garage is still there, but it's really hard to tell because it's only about 2 seconds of footage. The next area that we had a chance to see takes place right here in this military checkpoint. This is instead a small village, and then towering above that village is a gigantic radar array, and it looks just like this. This screenshot comes from the Ashes to Ashes mission in Black Ops Cold War, the final mission of the game. I won't spoil anything, but that radar array in the background looks pretty similar to what was in the leaked commercial. Another thing that we had a chance to see within this leak is a change to the dam. So the dam itself doesn't exist. All of the mechanical areas around it, the buildings around it, none of that is there. Instead, we have a viaduct bridge. This is what a viaduct bridge looks like. It's crossing from one side to the other. There's no water being held, but instead, there's a gigantic dirt path that leads up behind the bridge. Here's the craziest part about that. For the longest time, there have been rumors that underneath the ice at the dam, there's something. Whether it's something lurking or a hidden missile silo or a hidden bunker, that's kind of being confirmed here with this particular commercial, because at the end of that dirt path, it looks like there's a building or maybe a bunker of some sort. And me just seeing that in general, because that's something that I've been covering for a long time here, I really want to go to that location in particular. I want to see what the heck that is and what secrets there are to find. In the very next clip, we only see about 1 second of footage of this, but it shows a mine shaft and it's dimly lit. There is a track in order to pull a mine cart on, but I believe that this is most likely the beginning of the quarry. Instead of having the giant quarry like we have now, it's most likely going to be a series of tunnels and underground passages. If that's the case, I'm sure that this is going to be a very scary place to drop with lots of close quarters engagements, but that's my theory on it, because we only have 1 second of footage of it. We don't know exactly where this spot is. It could potentially be an area where bunkers are being linked together, but my mind is telling me this is most likely the beginning work of the quarry. There is one more clip that we're able to see, and this one unfortunately is only about a second long, so I'm going to do my best to break it down, but we get to see the Verdansk International Airport, and there's a big focus on the plane itself. It looks like it's directly out of the 80s. It definitely is much smaller than the planes that we see on the runway right now. In fact, it's so much smaller that instead of getting on through the terminal, you actually go on the runway, walk up a staircase, and get into the plane. I know that that still exists nowadays in smaller airports, which of course leads me to believe that maybe the Verdansk International Airport is much, much smaller than it is right now. Behind the plane, you can still see the air traffic control tower, so that still exists. It doesn't really look any different other than the fact that it's older, if that makes any sense, and it almost looks a little bit shorter, which also makes me believe that maybe we are at a smaller version of the Verdansk Airport, and that would make sense. You know, as time goes on, airports grow, and in the case of Verdansk, maybe it gets a little bit bigger. I guess we'll have to wait and see, but that is pretty much it. There was one more thing gameplay wise. It shows what I believe to be a flashback of downtown. And in this particular case, downtown has some changes made to that gigantic building that we're normally used to seeing. Instead of having the city hall building kind of rounded out, it's more square. And that is, of course, if I'm right on the area. I think this is the area where we have the city hall building. I could be mistaken, but so I just want to give you my opinion on the entire situation. Number one, someone is definitely getting sued, man. Like, there ain't no way. Someone's in big trouble because of this. Number two, am I worried about it getting boring too quick? Basically, what we saw is just a small sliver of what's going to change. I assume that they're going to be doing up the entire map, changing the entirety of the map. Sections may still apply, I'm assuming. Like, maybe we'll see similar buildings. Downtown, the bigger buildings will probably still be there because that makes sense. But for all the stuff that hasn't been built yet, like the stadium, I'm excited to explore that area. I'm excited to see what's found at the quarry, if that even exists at this point. What about the lumber mill? Does that still exist? Is the gulag still going to be there? Is it going to be completely different? Furthermore, I'm really wondering if this was done because of all the rumors that have been circulating about Call of Duty World War II Vanguard. Because if we're able to just snap in a flash and do a flashback and go back to the 80s, or, you know, go into the future or whatever, then we literally have free reign to go back and forth at any given time, no matter what happens in the storyline, because you're remembering it, I guess, or you're looking back on it with fond memories and you're remembering it as it was. So even if the map ends up getting nuked tomorrow, which we know it's not gonna get nuked tomorrow, there's still gonna be a map to play because we're remembering it from a different timeline. You know, that's like if they introduced a futuristic infinite warfare type game and then all of a sudden everything turns very futuristic and space station like. Could you imagine Warzone with wall running? I just thought about that. That would honestly be pretty crazy. Imagine there's two buildings close together and you jump it from wall to wall back and forth, running all the way up to the top instead of taking a staircase. Why am I talking about this? Anyway, point being, Call of Duty World War II doesn't matter now. It could go to World War II. It can go to World War I. It can go to futuristic infinite warfare again if it wanted to, because they could just go back and forth and back and forth. I don't know, man. That's confusing to me. And then furthermore, how is that going to make sense when it comes to the soldiers that we have in Modern Warfare? Some of the soldiers, if I'm remembering correctly, are pretty young. So, like, wouldn't they technically be kids in the 80s? So like, how would they be fighting? I don't know. Like, it's very strange in that sense. As for the leak about the Ural Mountain, I have no freaking clue. I mean, from what I understand and from all the people that have been talking about it online, the Ural Mountains were pretty much close to being done. There's no way that they scrapped the entire project. There's a possibility that maybe we see it come in bits and pieces in the future for Black Ops Cold War, but I don't know. With this revelation now, knowing that Warzone is going in a completely different direction, it really does make me wonder. But it was brought up to me in the comments section, and I think whoever said this, I don't remember, but I was talking about how the story didn't make any sense anymore, and people said, hey, do you really want the story to make sense? We're fighting literal zombies at this point. Touche, random internet commenter. Touche. But anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about here today. I'm sorry that I couldn't show you any images or video of the leaked commercial, but you probably don't want to see it in the state that it was shown anyway because, it wasn't done. I'm definitely interested in seeing what they're going to do with Verdansk and taking it back to the 80s, seemingly. They pretty much have free reign over it at that point. They could change up the terrain, they could change up the different locations, points of interest, and it could feel like a new map depending on what they do. I hope the overhaul is huge. Not just a couple of different spots, but the entire thing. Oh, and for those of you wondering, since the commercial wasn't finished, there was no end part talking about the release date or anything like that. So we don't entirely know when this is coming. Most likely season 3, somewhere around there. So probably like in a couple weeks, maybe. But anyway, that's everything I wanted to talk about here today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty folks, I will catch you on the next one. Peace.